All right. Well, let's go into the commission reports. I could not say the financial report any better than Ed has already done it. So I don't have any additional comments. Mark, do you have any comments, additional report on marketing?
Well, I think I will do the same thing you did, but I will turn this over to Eric, who's coordinating that effort. So, Eric, if you wouldn't mind, can you do the marketing update?
Yeah, you bet. You bet. As most of us are aware, we've moved into a direct sort of relationship with marketing practitioners for this coming season. So we've engaged a really incredible team of marketing experts to help the Cumberson Toltec on the digital marketing side, the media buy side, email marketing, social media marketing. So the plans have come together over the last couple of months. Those of you who are listening in, you'll likely see emails and posts on your favorite social channels coming soon, if not already seeing them. But we really actually have a great deal to talk about this coming season. As most of you know, we do have some different trips planned. We've got a couple of short route offerings. We've got a hop on in Cumbres to get over to Osier after the departure in Chama. So we're really looking forward to getting the message out, to informing our guests and followers on the program. But marketing, as you'll see, we will be doing some of the traditional marketing that you'll likely see some television spots in Colorado Springs, for example. You'll see some traditional print where you'd likely see it from former years, but you will see a continued increase in our digital presence across all the digital channels, across social. And we are trying to build a you know, continually more robust image and video library. So we are actually planning a campaign to ask the followers of the Cumbres and Toltec to potentially, you know, submit their photos and videos for our use to spread the word and share the experiences based on their own experience. So that's sort of the report today.
I think the only thing that I would piggyback on there is just an appreciation for Launch and the way they've handled the transition. They have set us up with a lot of the channels that we'll continue to use, whether it's the specialist that Launch contracted with. So they've been very helpful and very professional during the whole transition.
And they remain so. We engage Betsy and her team still. And as you said, Mark, you know, most of the practitioners and marketing experts that we have to help the Cumbres and Toltec directly, we're part of the team through Launch. So we're really appreciative of their support.
And Eric, you might just want to say a word about Abby on that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Abigail, who some of you may have talked to if you're on the line, if you've made a reservation, she's worked in reservations, she's worked in retail. She's been a part of the railroad for some time. Abigail has stepped up and has agreed to help the Cumbres and Toltec from a marketing coordination perspective. So she's the internal point of contact and liaison with our marketing experts to make sure that we're executing properly and on time and on budget.
We're really nice. very happy to have her, and she did an excellent job in her meeting yesterday presenting what's happening with marketing.
Agreed.
Dan?
Eric, I noticed from the rack card that Abby sent us yesterday a departure from the positioning of the railroad. I'm very happy and pleased that we are focusing on driving potential customers to our website and the whole electronic part of our upgrade, if you will, of our marketing. And using a much higher percentage of our money to stimulate electronic interest. The question is whether the authentic part of our message has just gone away or whether it's going to be used again. Our theory was that we're competing with a lot of people who can provide steam service, notably the guys over in Durango. We believe, and I hope it's not just telling ourselves a story, that the cumbersome Toltec is authentic in many ways, not only the equipment, the steam, but the actual experience of riding the 64 miles, which is the longest and highest. And that development has fortuitously, nothing we've caused, but development has been notably absent. So if you ride on our services, you really are being transported to what John calls 64 miles of 1880. That seems to me to be a valuable point of distinction with regard to other tourist railroads. I hate to say it, nothing really original other than the mine left on the loop, despite the very good job that Mark does in presenting an historic experience. So you name it, Royal Gorge, which is not steam, but our competitors are at a disadvantage to really say, if you want to understand and experience the 1880s, we're it. We use that, or under the theory anyway, that was one advantage that the cumbersome Toltec can use to offset its unfortunate location. Getting to us, finding place to stay and eat and all that, it's sort of a challenge. And so I'm raising the question whether this was a conscious decision on our part to depart from authentic, and what its future role is in our positioning.
Yeah, absolutely not. We have not departed from the authentic positioning. Since we moved to a rack card specific to the brochure, we used to have quite a few pages to get our message out. Since now we have literally a two-sided rack card, we've had to really consolidate our message and try to get the information that might immediately attract somebody that might be picking up a card above the fold. So we tried to use railroad, train, experience, that sort of thing. And then, try to tell the story and then getting them to the site where they can really immerse themselves into the cumbersome Toltec experience. But by no stretch are we departing from the historic nature to transport your time back transport yourself in time, because that is really, a huge differentiator for the railroad. We may use different words occasionally that might resonate with a different sort of population or demographic that still sort of resonates or tries to resonate with that same message. But no, the historic part of the railroad will certainly continue to be what we will use as a factor to inform and attract guests and riders.
Thank you. That's great.
You bet.
Any other questions about marketing or anything we want to talk on that subject? I think what we'll do, Eric, I would like Eric to talk about the various trips, but let's wait till we get through the other commissioner reports. And so, Billy, anything that you'd like to talk about local affairs?